that time of the night where we actually invite the Nation Media Group CEO, that's Elena Skitahi. He has been steering that company for the last 7 years. And of course, it is now the largest independent media house in East and Central Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, help me in welcoming the CEO of Nation Media Group, Elena Skitahi.
A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
Our CS, Minister of Devolution and Planning, Madam Anwa Igoro. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and all invited guests, my colleagues, KPMG, good evening. I've just been told to make a few remarks, and I'll first start by saying this is one of my most important evenings in our calendar. And the reason is the Top 100 initiative is something that we started from scratch 6 years ago. And the reason we started that, and we've said this a couple of times, I do not tire to say, is because we realized that the real drivers of the Kenya economy are the small and medium-sized enterprises that are dotted all over the country, and which at that time did not have a forum where they would be appreciated. And that is how we came together with KPMG, and I remember sitting in the office and saying, what shall we even call it? And there was even a thought of calling it the Top 500, because there's something that had happened, I think, in UK around 500. In the end, we settled for Top 100, and we have never looked back. And every year, and even now as I look around, every year it has become bigger and better. But for us, the satisfaction is that this is not just a gathering of people who did not have something better to do, but is a gathering of people who actually have done well. I think we had quite a couple of 100 entries, and this is the cream of those top 100 businesses. Businesses that are happy to give their accounts to be audited, businesses that are happy to open their books to people to look at, and businesses that are happy to share their excellence. The responsibility for us to create jobs, to move the economy forward, to achieve the Vision 2030, to even grow the economy by double digits, actually rests among the people present today. And your colleagues who may not have made it to Top 100, but who as well are doing their bit to ensure that we move forward. No one else is going to grow this economy for us. We are going places. We have a huge opportunity. We have a fantastic environment for us to make a difference and leave a legacy for those that come after us, and even more importantly, for our families. We must, again, drive professionalism within our businesses. Many of these businesses today are family-run. Nothing wrong with that. But as we grow, and if you want to go to all these other places, you might find that you might stretch your family too much. And I think this is an opportunity that we have to start making it a professionally run business where even other members of the family can come and work in Nation or the other place where their talents may be even better deployed. In fact, I want to say one of the people who mentored me over the years, and I'm happy to talk about him because he's a good friend of mine, is a gentleman called Bharat Thakra. Bharat Thakra started almost a family-run business. But one thing I admired about Bharat is that he refused to settle at family-run business. Today, Scanard is not only a company listed in the stock exchange, but I think it is in over 10 countries around Africa. Now, this is what we must emulate. This is what we must do to become world-class. And I think the people in this room are all destined to become world-class. I want to congratulate you. I want to appreciate you. And I really want to say asanteni sana, and let's keep going, because this is Africa's time. This is Kenya's time. Thank you very much.